Are you ready to uncover your retirement solution? Learn more as Jeremy Keil and his guests guide you along the path of retirement and reveal the 5 steps you need to take to solve your retirement puzzle. Now, on to the show.
Hello and welcome to Retirement Revealed with Jeremy Keil. Today we're going to be talking about getting back to the basics. What's up, Jeremy?
Not too much. How are you doing, Eric?
I am energetic, excited. I'm stir crazy, you know, the whole social distancing, mm-hmm. you know, working from my basement. Well, I've been doing that for years, you know, so I've been practicing social distancing for, I think, what, 7-8 years? I think we've talked about that before. So I'm getting pretty good at it. It would be nice to be able to get together with friends and talk over, you know, coffee across a table or something instead of Zoom meetings and mm-hmm. weird phone calls and FaceTime and all that. But it's still nice to be able to talk to folks like you.
Yeah. Absolutely. Well, I'm glad to have you on the line here.
Yeah, me too. You told me that before we even started this that we're going to get back to basics, which I think is a pretty good idea right about now, right? I mean, with everything that's going on, it's nice to kind of hit that reset button on a few things, and getting back to basics is a good topic for today. So what exactly are you talking about?
Yeah, we're talking about investing, just the basics of investing. There's so many people you run into that they have hundreds of thousands, they might have millions of dollars because they are great savers, but they consistently don't know or haven't been educated yet in the ways that investing works. And that's okay, I don't blame you. It's not like every single person's forced to take an investing class in high school or college. And the unfortunate part is a lot of times other financial advisors make it more complicated than it seems. And we just believe so much in education. We believe so much that if you know about your money, you'll feel better about your money and you'll make better decisions about your money. So that's what we want to make sure is, let's just cover the basics of investing today.
All right. Sounds good. So where do we start with the basics? What's the first thing?
Well, let's just think about the different types of investments that are out there. And we're just going to try to keep it simple. But basically, when you're investing, you're either getting stocks, bonds, real estate, or cash. Those are the 4 areas.
Okay.
And most of the time, it's stocks and bonds make up the vast majority of the portfolio of your investments. Mm-hmm. But there's still the chance to own real estate. There's still a chance to have some cash. A lot of times people view their cash type accounts as more like, oh, that's my savings account. But cash is still a big part of your investing portfolio of your investments. So stocks, bonds, real estate, and cash. That's the 4 main places.
Gotcha. Okay. So stocks was your first one. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think most people understand what stocks are in a way. You know, it's a piece of a company that you own and that the value goes up or the value goes down.
Yeah, you got it. Think of, you own stocks and bonds are a loan. So if you hear the word stock, you own a piece of that company. If you hear the word bond, you actually gave a loan to a company. Mm. It might be the same company. Where it gets a little confusing is there's so many different ways you can own stocks. So we'll talk to people, we'll say, I don't have any stocks. Well, it turns out you've got 200 grand in stock mutual funds. Yes, you do. You own stocks. So just real quick, there's 3 main ways you can own stocks. You can either own the individual stock, like you just might own Apple or Harley Davidson or whatever it might be. You own that actual stock, one stock, you own that. Then there's something called a mutual fund, which means that you trusted somebody else to go out and buy a collection of stocks. Mutual means kind of, hey, we're all in it together, because it's not just you. Mm-hmm. There's thousands of people that are part of this mutual fund. So each of you go ahead, throw some money in this mutual fund. The manager goes out and buys stocks. Then there's a newer way, you know, newer in the last 20 years or so, called an exchange traded fund. And those are somewhat similar to mutual funds in that it's a collection of stocks, but it's also similar to having an individual stock in that you can trade, you can buy and sell these exchange traded funds throughout the day. So they have different prices from, we're in Central Time Zone, we're in Wisconsin. The stock market's generally open between 8:30 a.m. and 3 p.m. You can go buy your exchange traded fund. A lot of people call them ETFs, right? That's the acronym for it. You can buy that throughout the day. Meanwhile, a mutual fund, you can send your money to the mutual fund company anytime between 8:30 and 3, but they're not going out and trading that. They're waiting until